Available. And the start of this half, Steve, I just noticed the official signals that it's the big green is going to receive, big green giant.
And of course, Feletra, his favorite receiver, Jeremy Nye, 2 touchdowns last week, 2 touchdowns this week. And where has he been? I mean, he didn't even play last year.
No, he was playing soccer last year. They seen him out in that soccer field, and then his basketball coach noticed the great hands he had, and he talked him into coming out for football.
So Somersworth kicking off here to start the third quarter of play. 16-yard touchdown pass in the first quarter, a 46-yard touchdown pass in the second quarter. That's how the scoring is gone. So Jeremy Nye will start the action for Somersworth. He will kick off, and he lays into a short boot as it bounces on the 20, back to the 15, and here comes the run back. Straight up the middle goes Seeley, and he's out in the open once again. He breaks a couple tackles, and he's inside the 40. Once again, Brian Seeley almost does the whole thing.
Comes right up that middle, and he's got a big wide hole.
As they have the ball on the Somersworth 37-yard line.
Well, that's interesting. That's 2 kickoffs in a row. Same play.
They've got a kick away from that guy.
But at the sidelines. Well, although what's lacking with him is speed. If he had speed, he'd be all the way, Steve.
First and 10 for Bishop Brady. They have the ball on the Somersworth 37. Second back through, gets the call, finds an opening, drives across the 35-yard line to about the 34. That was a carry by Sean Ryder.
Yeah. Brought down by Scott Brown. Scott Brown's only a junior.
Second and 6 for the Green Giants. And they have to be proud of themselves. Their defense did a very admirable job, especially on the run. Their offense has not been able to get too much going. Right now, they seem to be, there's a stoppage right at the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard loss.
And there's a horde of tacklers led by Big Mike Chapman, number 33.
Brings the ball back to the 35-yard line. The offense just hasn't been able to get on track. The defense is held in there. So it's 3rd and 7 for Brady.
And you think now that Brian Seeley, the quarterback, will put this up in the air.
Let's see if they go to the air.
Somersworth defense, secondary defense, playing tight.
Seeley goes back, here comes the rush. Oh, Cockshell! Cockshell makes him pop up the ball, and here goes Chapman. Chapman takes it down inside the 25. It was Cockshell who popped up that ball.
And that thing looked like a hot potato. Nobody wanted it on the run. Finally, it was picked up by Mike Chapman.
On every pass attempt, someone from Somersworth has been right in on Seeley.
And I think that same fellow, as you mentioned, big number 7, John Cockshell.
And that ball bounced for about 15 yards before Mike Chapman picked it up. The ball is now on the 23-yard line, a big break for Somersworth.
And put in the air.
Fletcher is quarterbacking once again as the give is on the left side for no go. Mike Chapman on the carry. Maybe a half a yard gain, that's about it.
Mike taking himself out of the ballgame.
And Scott Brown comes in. Second down and 9, the ball is on the 22. It's a perfect day for football, Jim, weather-wise.
Oh, fantastic. Few clouds.
All right, the give. Oh, what a break for Gilmette right up the middle. A big opening.
Beautiful.
Down to the 10-yard line. Gilmette had a truck.
He just went off tackle, big opening, made one little juke move, and took himself up about 10, 11 yards.
Enough for a first down on the 10-yard line. It's just shy of the 10-yard line, so they can get a first down.
Yep, without scoring.
Somersworth driving right here. So Filletra back in and seems to be doing okay. Back to pass as he rolls out to the left side, looks, and he's going to be hounded as a flag as the ball is thrown away. But a flag, and it's a holding call going against Somersworth, as the indication is against Brian Caron.
I'll tell you, Tony did a real good job getting rid of that ball. A lot of these pro quarterbacks should take some lessons from him.
That was the first time that Tony was not able to complete a pass.
Yeah, he's able to do that, Steve, because he seems to have that quick release once he lets it go. Hard to take him down.
No doubt that Brady will take that penalty because the ball is down at just shy of the 10-yard line. But it looks as though it's going to go against where the infraction was.
No signals as yet.
As it brings the ball is brought back to the 26. Should be a holding call, and it is.
It is.
Holding call, and that brings Somersworth way back to the 26.
That was a big, big loss on that one.
So it'll be first down, and, we could say 25 yards for a first down.
And you know what, with an arm like Tony, that's not too much to make up.
Option play, and it's pitched out. Going wide is Gilmette. He picks up a couple of yards.
Good play, good call on that one.
It looks as though Filletra is hurt once again.
He's coming out. Oh, no, he's looking for the play.
Tony having a tough afternoon as he was banged up once again on that option play. He stays in there, though, as Chapman is back in the game as well. Second down. The ball is on the 22-yard line, so about 21 yards to go. Passing formation as everyone is split out. And a draw play to Chapman. He's hit at the line of scrimmage, fights his way across the 20, but it's only a couple of yards gain.
Good call.
Give credit to the Brady defense. They've been very effective on the run.
You had Wayne Robbie making all the motions out there to get for his team to get back in the secondary.
Ball is on the 19-yard line. Third down and 18 yards to go for a first down, 19 to go for a TD. Let's see if Filletra puts it in the air as Somersworth just spreads out left and right. Only one setback behind Filletra, that's Chapman. Fluff is in motion, and it almost looked as though he turned upfield. Here comes the rush. The ball is thrown in the end zone, and there's somebody there, but thrown too far for Fluff, and even if he caught it.
Out of play, but that was still a beautiful pass thrown by Tony Filletra. Now, I think they're in fourth down territory.
Now, do you think that Jeremy Nye will try for a field goal or what?
Well, he was popping them up in pregame practice from the 30 with no problems at all.
Tony Filletra, 5 for 5 in the first half. The second half so far, he's 0 for 2.
Yeah, they're going to try it, aren't
they? Let's see if they're going for it.
They're in punt formation.
Jeremy Nye, what's he doing? Is it going to be a field goal? Yes, a field goal attempt. Ball is dropped. Jeremy Nye is forced to throw. He's going to be hit from behind. No, he gets it away. Complete to Fluff, who's thrown out of bounds short of a first down.
Well, I guess they lost the rhythm on every part of that play. It was a fake field goal. Then they were going to field goal it, and it was a pass.
Hardy's Market and Deli, located at 303 Main Street in Somersworth. For years, the most popular place in town for subs and sandwiches. And just look at the bountiful and delicious helpings carefully prepared just for you. Call in or fax your order ahead of time. Hardy's has one of the largest coolers in town, and that means the coldest and the most refreshing of beverages, featuring Pepsi by the case, the six-pack, or by the individual can. Remember that Hardy's is a full-service market and deli, and that now includes video rentals as well as Megabucks tickets. Stop by and say hello to Gino and Chris, Somersworth's happiest couple, at Hardy's Market and Deli, located at 303 Main Street in Somersworth. Spinelli's Italian Restaurant, Route 125 in Milton, now offering early bird specials at fantastic savings. Spinelli's has a daily lunch menu starting at $2.99. And now there's weekend breakfast from 7 a.m. until noon. Everything is made to order and made to your liking. Fine Italian cuisine, ocean fresh seafood, and barbecue. It's an Italian restaurant run by a dedicated family. Treat yourself to something special at Spinelli's Italian Restaurant off Route 125, Exit 17, Spalding Turnpike.
That formation just didn't look right from the start.
A little confusion in there.
But give credit to Jeremy Knight, a heads-up thinking as he threw for completion at least.
Just as good as a punt.
As the ball is now placed on the 13-yard line, first and 10 for Brady.
Got to give Brady credit, too, for holding him on that downs.
First and 10. Now the give on the left side of the line is crashing in there is Dave Fortier. He gets it up to the 15, probably just a two-yard gain.
Jason Pluff in on attack along with Mike Chapman. Shot gain on that play.
Well, I'm very impressed with Brady's defense. They've played an excellent game. They've kept the team within shooting range. It's only 14-0, two touchdowns lead by Somersworth.
See if they come on the right side.
Mm-hmm. Hit at the line of scrimmage. Working his way forward for 1 or 2 yards. And once again, 40 are on the carry. So the ground game just isn't working for Brady as the ball is now on the 12-yard line. It'll be third down and 6 yards for a first down.
Brady seems to be working on the left side of the topper's line.
But interestingly, Jim, they haven't gone to that pitch out to the left side that has worked so well.
Mike Chapman playing right on the line.
And the ball is a drop behind the line of scrimmage, a big loss back to the 15. That play didn't work whatsoever.
Not at all. This is definitely a punt situation.
And Fletcher was in on the defense of that play. Surprisingly, you would think that...
Very much so.
You'd think that he would get a little bit of a breather because he's been banged up. But in any case, fourth down, Brady forced to punt as Baumeister is back at his 1 yard line. It's going to be a big punting situation. Let's see how he does. He gets a good snap. Here's the rush, but he gets it away. As
Gilmet
tries to field it, finally does, is hit immediately and thrown down. He has the ball inside of the Brady 40, though, so good position for the toppers as they will start out on the Brady. Let's see where they place the ball, 38-yard line.
That wind is still gusty up there, Steve, and I think it's not too easy to handle a ball on a day like this.
4:47 remaining here in the third quarter of play. Somersworth trying to get their offense moving once again. They haven't been on track in the second half. Here comes Jason Pluff. Pluff finds an opening as he's out in the open, but look at that. A flag is thrown as Pluff goes for big yardage inside the 10. They're going to bring it back.
That flag wasn't thrown, Steve, until Pluff was on the 20-yard line. A very delayed flag on that play.
So the two penalties have been killers here in the second half. The first one was a holding call. Now let's see what this infraction is. Another holding call.
Yes. It was a very delayed call.
Coach Jim Keyes of Somersworth may bring home a victory this afternoon, but he's going to have a few things to work on with the team.
You know, actually, Steve, that's about a 35-yard loss when you combine the two, the gain and the penalty.
Ball is brought back to the 46-yard line. Well, Fluff brought it down to the 10. Here it is at the 46.
Big loss.
Yeah, big loss. Still a first down situation for the toppers. They have the ball on the Brady 46. Now pitch up for Jason Plouffe. He's got good blocking here.
Look at how he followed that blocking.
He's tripped up inside the 40, but he gained 6 or 7 yards.
Good movement on Plouffe that time. When he got the ball, he just waited for his blockers up front and then dashed straight ahead.
Ball is placed on the 39-yard line, and that'll be a second down and 11 for the Toppers.
Which we call a Mike Chapman time. What are the odds of him not getting the ball?
Well, they may go in the air. I don't know exactly how well Fletcher feels right now. He may be a little bit tentative, but let's see. He's going in the air. Good protection. Oh. Looks downfield. Nice throw. Has a man there. Oh, off the fingertips of Jeremy Nye. And Nye was open once again.
All the way. The first one he dropped. Again, it was just a fantastic play by Tony Fletcher. Led him real well.
Just off the fingertips of Jeremy Nye.
And you call that right. Second down and only a half a yard to go, and he put the ball in the air. Good play. Good call.
Well, it's second and 11. They're on.
Oh, there you are. So I was giving you credit for that.
Now it's third down. And once again, Fletcher with a beautiful pass. Just a little bit too far.
Put it in the air again.
Third and 11. Back to pass. Good protection once again. And he throws short this time. Complete.
First down.
But it's enough for a first down. It looks like Chapman, the receiver. Yes, Mike Chapman with a first down reception.
Tell you, Steve, this kid can throw.
That time he found, I'm sure Chapman wasn't the primary receiver that time.
Looking down the field, he had three or four ball players wide open.
Timeout for Brady with 3:39 remaining here in the third quarter of play as we check the Floral Creations scoreboard. Floral Creations, located at Route 108 in Dover.
Dumont's Hardware, 77 High Street in Somersworth, is a complete center for plumbing and electrical supplies and tools of all kinds. Home and garden supplies are available as well. Plus, an entire section is devoted to welding and accessories. Dumont's has a large area devoted to paints and stains, providing the perfect selections. Come into Dumont's and be surprised at what's available, including expert window and screen repair, along with many other services just for you. Open 7 days a week for your convenience, it's Dumont's Hardware, 77 High Street in Somersworth, your neighborhood store.
So far, Brady has kept Somersworth scoreless in the second half.
I think if Somersworth scores this time, it'll all be over, but the cheering. It'll break the game wide open.
First and 10 for Somersworth on the Brady 23. All right, the give is to Gilmet. Look at him weave around as he gets inside the 20. Gilmet has carried quite a few times this afternoon, Jim.
Yeah, and that stop was by the quarterback, Ryan Seeley.
So Somersworth is utilizing all three of their running backs this afternoon, and they've been quite effective. Second and 5. The ball is in, let's see, the 18-yard line. Jeremy Nye splits out on the left side. Let's see if they go to him. No, it's a pitch out going wide to the right side. Gilmet once again as he holds onto the ball, gets it across the 15-yard line, very close to a first down.
Probably measurement time. There it is.
Now they're going to probably have to measure. This one's going to be a close call. They're still analyzing the situation. And they say, well, look at the official. He's going over to the sideline marker because he's saying the second down marker should be closer to the goal line.
Putting a third down.
Third down and about a half yard to go for a first. Now they're going to call for a measurement. What do you think, Jim?
I think he's going to be short by inches. It's my guess.
It looks like it's going to be short. Let's see what the situation is as they stretch it out. It is going to be short by just a half a yard. Half a yard or less. So it'll be third down for Somersworth. The ball is on the 14-yard line.
And it's a situation, Steve, where they have two downs to make it in, because they are definitely in four-down territory where they are.
Normally, they probably would do a quarterback sneak with Pletra somewhat injured. They may just stick to Chapman.
Yeah, Chapman. Either one of the two.
Third and inches. Chapman gets the call, gets the first down, and Morrissey break two tackles. Look at him go into the end zone. 14-yard run, and he did it by himself.
And those knees are going high. He's very elated, very happy. A lot of enthusiasm shown there at the topper sideline. They seem to be breaking this game wide open, as I mentioned, Steve, with that touchdown.
That was a great run by Mike Chapman. And that pretty well puts it out of reach, as Chapman did it all on his own. 20-0 the score. Jeremy Nye going for the point after. There's the snap. The ball is down. This time it looks good, and it is 21-0 as we check once again the Floral Creation scoreboard.
Nard's TV and Appliance Store, 74 High Street in Somersworth, carrying a full line of GE products. And now featuring the well-known and well-respected line of Hotpoint appliances. Now you have your choice of beautiful and the most modern up-to-date appliances at reasonable prices. Nard's is famous for its selection of TVs, all sizes and styles from the most economical to the widescreen, plus the latest in VCR equipment and cameras. And remember that Nard's always services what they sell. Nard's TV and Appliance Store, now featuring GE and Hotpoint, 74 High Street in Somersworth.
21-0 with 2:43 remaining here in the third quarter of play, Jim. You were saying?
I was saying that once the Toppers get the ball, they'll keep that ball right on the ground. That'll eat up the clock.
Jeremy Nye kicking off once again. He's their leading scorer so far this season, Jim. Four touchdowns. And he's got six extra points. That one touched one of the players, so it's a fair ball. Even if it went out of bounds, it would have counted. The ball is downed inside the 30. So Brady will start out. They placed the ball on the 27-yard line.
Well, this is that name I was kicking around with. That tackle was made by Rick DeShaharnas. Good stop.
He saw quite a bit of action in the second half last week, along with a number of other players. So Brady comes out once again. They've had their problems on offense. And the give on the left side to Fortier. Fortier crosses the 30. Picks up about three or four. Let's see where they place the ball. It's on the 32-yard line, so a gain of, well, it's just a little over 4 yards. We'll give him five.
High tackle there by Tom McCallion, number 65. He's been getting quite a few tackles. He's a big boy. He's 5'9", 165 pounds.
Minute 45 remaining in the third quarter of play. Second and five, here's the give. There's the patented third, the sweep on the left side, and it's good for another first down. I think they've gained a first down every time they've run that play.
And they forget about it. Well, you got a man hurt there.
That was Scott Brown, who seems to be shaken up. But Fortier once again running, this time up to the 45, but we've got a flag down on the play. Let's take a look at the officials and see what they indicate, whether it's a clip or a holding call.
Yeah, that tackle was made by Alan Pimentel. Goes off limping.
Yeah, that was
20.
20 is Pimentel, you're right. Holding call against Brady, so that negates a very good run. Bring the ball way back.
We've noticed all afternoon that left side of the line, they've been getting large yardage, but they're not using it as much as they should, Steve.
Brings the ball back to the 23-yard line. It'll be second down and 14.
Second down 15. 23-yard line.
Minute 21 remaining here in the third quarter of play. Brendan Seeley, I don't think he's going to go to the air. He's been kind of gun-shy about that. But they go back to that play. This time they stop it. Right at the 25. The pitch out to the left side didn't work for the first time.
No, and a lot of crushing tackling going on there. That play was stopped by Dan Devlin.
Ryder on the carry, but only a gain of two or three.
Devlin stands at 6 feet, 170 pounds. He's only a sophomore.
Third down and 12 for the Green Giants, as they're down by 21 points here in the third quarter. Only 40 seconds left. Now the pitch out going wide to the right side, getting across the 25. That's as far as it goes. It looked as though there was going to be an opening there. It closed quickly. That's Joe Timmons on the carry.
And the tackle was by Tony Feletra. That's what speed does to you. Once they go around the ends with the speed that the toppers have, it's very hard to get around those players.
Only 12 seconds left. I don't think Brady will get this off before the end of the third quarter. Down to five as they're taking their time. And that should end it. Here's the whistle, end of the third quarter of play. After three quarters, we check the Plural Creation scoreboard. 21 to nothing the score. Somersworth in the lead over Bishop Brady. Back in a moment.
The Gateway Family Restaurant at the Lee Traffic Circle is one of the most successful enterprises in the entire state. And it's because of the personable service as soon as you walk in. And that comes directly from the owners and all of the employees. What's important is that it is genuine. You are treated as a friend. The Gateway is also most successful because of the vast selections of food for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Everything is cooked to order, such as steaks and burgers on the grill, or seafood items, sandwiches, a full line of traditional favorites such as meatloaf, chicken, or spaghetti, plus Cajun spice foods. The Gateway even makes their own bread. People keep coming back because it's an enjoyable experience. A family restaurant, owned and operated by a family, and including a family of employees and customers. That equals Gateway Family Restaurant at the Lee Traffic Circle.
Start of the fourth and final, Jim. 21 to nothing is the score. Somersworth has dominated, but Brady has played well.
They did play well, and we got a good chance to see what a full game the Toppers can play, and they did well themselves.
Baumeister punting. He's back at about his 13. Jamie Pluff is back for Somersworth to receive. He's back inside his own 30. Somersworth has put on quite a rush. The couple of the kicks. Here comes another rush, but they let it go.
Who's got it?
Pluff has it at his own 35. Heading for the right sideline. Cuts inside. And he gets back to the midfield stripe. Now, that time, the Somersworth defense was right on top of the punter, but they elected not to try to block it.
Went right by him. Tackle made by Devin McGahan. Well, we'll see how much of the clock they'll lead up now. I doubt if they'll put that ball in the air.
Ball on the 49-yard line. First and 10 for Somersworth. And the second back through gets the call. Jason Pluff.
Still on his feet.
Oh, I thought he was going to break that tackle. Finally, he's brought down. But forward progress, it should be about a 5-yard pickup. As they place the ball on the 44-yard line. Second and 5 for Somersworth. Next week, Somersworth travels to Newport.
That should be a good one, Steve. They're talking about the highlights of this Newport team. They're strong, they're fast. Game will be played at Newport.
First back through gets the call up the middle. That looks like Chapman. Chapman is met by a host of tacklers. May have picked up a yard.
As you mentioned, there was a whole horde of tacklers led by Brian Seeley.
Ball is on the 38-yard line. Third down and 4 for Somersworth. 10:35 remaining in the contest. Two touchdown passes, Fletcher to Jeremy Nye, and a 14-yard run by Mike Chapman. And the score is now 21 to nothing. A touchdown in each quarter. Now it's an option run by Fletcher. Nice one over to Fluff. He's getting back to the line of scrimmage, and then he breaks open for a first down. He was hit by at least three players and made a first down. Good run by Jason Pluff.
Jason's got a tremendous amount of speed, especially in his takeoff. He's got a burst. Quick starts by the kid.
Brings the ball to the 37-yard line. So Somersworth is eating up the clock, Jim. Now it's a give on the right side. Chapman busts forward for about a 4-yard pickup.
Yeah, you mentioned the clock. As long as that ball keeps on the ground, that clock will keep ticking. And as we mentioned, that's the biggest enemy that the big green Giants have now is the clock.
Ball is on the 34-yard line, 2nd and 7 for Somersworth. As Fletcher looked to be seriously injured in the first half, comes back, and he's played the entire second half, both on offense and defense. On the right side, straight ahead goes, is that Pluff? I believe it's Jason Pluff. Let's see.
34.
Yep, Jason Pluff on the bottom of the pile.
Drawing in the middle. He goes in the middle around the ends.
Brings it up to the 31-yard line. Third and, let's see, it's a long three. Third and a long three for Somersworth. 9:09 remaining here in the first and the fourth quarter.
Tony is looking real good out there since the half started. And they are keeping the ball on the ground. Let's see if they do it on this third down.
Jeremy Nye split out to the left side. And the give is to Pluff. He doesn't make a first down as he gets it up to the 30, only a yard pickup.
They'll try it again.
So now it's a fourth down play for Somersworth.
Yeah, they're still in that fourth down territory. They won't give it up by a kick.
Fourth and a long two and a half. 8:30 remaining.
Now I might be trying to talk him into a field goal. It's not.
Let's see if they stay on the ground as they have Jeremy Nye split off on the right side this time. Back to pass as Fletcher fakes, throws. It's off of the fingertips of Chapman. It was kind of a wobbly pass, and Fletcher got belted once again.
Yeah, you know, with a pump fake, he had his man, but right off the fingertips, as you mentioned.
Fletcher's taking a beating in this game. He's getting hit very hard when he releases the ball.
He's a tough kid. He can take it. He'll be there next week.
So Bishop Brady takes over. They have the ball on their own 30-yard line with 8:09 remaining.
Well, the Toppers have something at stake now. They kept the opposing team in the first game scoreless, and they're going to try to do it with the big green Giants.
Brendan Seeley calling the signals, and the give is on the right side and caught behind the line of scrimmage by Chapman. That's Seeley on the carry, but he loses a yard. Chapman just busted right through there and grabbed him.
He's a bull, both end, offensive and defense.
And you have to give the offense of Brady credit. They've been trying all afternoon with all kinds of plays. They're staying away from that passing attack. The pass rush has just been overwhelming.
And they're playing a real good gutty game out there.
Wing back on the right side. He's in motion this time. Long count. And the pitch out going wide to the right side. Met right at the 30-yard line. Wow. Look at that. Four defenders right there.
What I don't understand there, that you see big number 12, Tony Fletcher, in on the tackle. You would think that he'd have him out of this game, preventing him from getting hurt, any serious injury.
That was Dave Fortier on the carry, but it's only a 1-yard pickup. It'll be 3rd and 10 with 6:58 remaining. Scott Brown is limping a little bit as well.
You got key men in there now for the Toppers.
Third down play. Is this going to be one that they're going to throw in the air? No, it's pitch out going wide right. crossing the 30, picking up a couple. That's as far as 40 can get. Given 3 yards on the carry.
Now the question is, will the big green giant give up that ball?
Fourth down, they have 7 yards to go for a first. And they have the ball on their own 33.
Clock is still going.
Baumeister is back. He's dropping back to his own 20. Jason Pluff will be going back to receive. Now let's see what kind of snap. Good snap. Here comes the rush once again, and it's a high kick. Pluff gets it at his own 35, heading for the right side once again, and they finally catch up to him.
Got a flag on the play, Steve.
As he brings it up to about the 47-yard line, there's a flag back upfield. Now they stayed away from the punter. They stayed away from the punter this time. Let's see what the infraction is. Who are they going to talk to?
Well, you're going to see
they're talking with themselves. They're talking with Somersworth.
Yeah. Probably take the ball there. They have the option whether to take the ball back again, replay it, or take the ball where it is now.
Might as well keep it. Might as well keep it.
Backfield. Illegal procedure.
Yep, they decline. They take over the ball. With 5:47 remaining, they have the ball on their own 47. 48. Certainly wouldn't have done them any good to do the replay on that.
Now, I think what Somersworth's going to do now is just eat up the clock. Keep the ball on the ground.
They keep their players in from the start.
That's a surprising thing to me to say, is to keep those key players in the game.
First and 10 on the left side as the ball is brought up to the midfield stripe. That was Jason Pluff. Pluff has had a good workout this afternoon.
Yeah. That tackle made by Matt Boyer. Matt's a big boy. He's 6 feet, 170 pounds. He's only a junior.
Gain of only one on the play, so second and 9. Clock keeps ticking away. It's now 5:02 remaining. And Fletra right up the middle as the ball is advanced to about the 48-yard line of Brady.
Great defense by the big green Giants. Yeah, the whole center of the line going forward. Big number 70 was in there.
That was Chapman on the carry, so it's third down and 7.
Shane McCarthy in on the tackle.
So last week, Somersworth shut out their opponent 48-0. That was Fall Mountain. And right now, with 4:23 remaining, they look as though they may shut out Bishop Brady as well. First down run that time.
Quick opening play, and he just took off like a cannon, making the first down.
And that was Scott Brown. Scott Brown in the backfield right now, and he just shot right through the line.
That line just bursted forward. You just could see the green jerseys going backward.
So now they finally substitute quarterbacks. Aaron Hodgson is in there. First and 10 with the ball on the Brady 39.
Now, if I know Tony Fletcher.
Well, it's Hodgson in there now, and the give is over on the right side. Brown has it. Brown going for another first down. How about that?
Even had the cameras fooled on that one.
Now,
what I'm about to say, Steve, is that knowing Tony Fletcher, he's just talking to the coach, say, hey, coach, what's going on? I only played a half the first game, and you're taking me out now. I want to play.
And they finally give the starting backfield a rest as Gilmette, Pluff, and let's see, is Chapman out of there? Yep. Yeah. So they're going to give the remaining squad a chance to play here and finish up the game. Good run on the left side that time. Rick Descharnay.
Flag on the play.
Rick Descharnay and Hevia ran well last week.
See a hold.
Yeah.
Hoppers.
Another holding call, but you got to be impressed with the second team that comes in there. They play very well. They did last week. And so far, they are doing very well this week.
Good rhythm out there and pushing forward.
He's certainly getting enough game experience. 3:46 remaining in the contest. The ball is now on the 34-yard line on that holding call. It'll be first. First and, oh, let's see, about 18?
No.
First and about 18. Aaron Hodgson calling the signals right now. T formation, the back who gets it is Scott Brown. Scott Brown trying to fight off tacklers. There's just too many of them.
Just holding them.
He gets back to the line of scrimmage. Second down play, 3:20 remaining.
I think on that play there, trying to follow him is Jamie Bomerster. Well, that's the game plan of Somersworth right now. Just keep that clock moving.
Second and 10. On the right side, a gain of one. But that's fine as far as Somersworth is concerned. They are eating up the clock. They're giving game experience to some of the second string team. And the second team is doing a very good job.
And they're getting, as you mentioned, that great experience because on paper, it should be quite a ball game next week between Newport and the Toppers.
2:30 remaining now. And the pitch off going wide as the ball is brought back to the line of scrimmage. Squirting forward, Desharnais. Desharnais picks up a couple of yards as he fought for every inch of it.
22, number 22 on the Green Giants, 77 in on the stop, 76 on the stop.
I'm sorry, 27 is Chris Hawthorne. We want to give credit to proper people who are running, and Hawthorne carried that time and did a good job. Minute 54 remaining now. As the ball is placed on the 32-yard line, fourth down, there's still a ton of yards to go for a first. They're just going to keep it on the ground. There's about 14 yards to go for a first. Now Desharnais has it. Desharnais going wide, being strung out, cuts up field, dances his way forward to about the 25-yard line. Short of a first down, but a good run by Rick Desharnais.
It certainly was. He ran out of territory there at the sidelines, just made a good body twist and gained some yardage.
Minute 31 remaining now. Brady will have time for just a couple of more plays. And the incentive for Somersworth is to maintain that shutout.
And that was good sportsman showed by Jim Keyes. Instead of putting that ball in the air, took out his first ringers, put in the reserves, not to pile up that score.
Clock is ticking as we're down to a minute 24. On the play, behind the line, Somersworth defense is not given an inch.
Give credit for that tackle, Bob Gosling. He played one heck of a game all day. Made a good play on that one. Bob is a big boy. Bob stands at 6'4", 260 pounds.
Now back to the line of scrimmage once again as Brady going for a quick setup, trying to get as many plays in as they possibly can. They still haven't been able to gain anything. That's third down and 10. The ball remains on the 25-yard line. There's 38 seconds remaining. And the give right up the middle. Only a yard gain.
You got to give an awful lot of respect for the Toppers there. They get their second and third stringers in there. They're doing a bang-up job in that line.
Fourth down, last play of the game as we have 17 seconds remaining. Last play of the game.
You hope.
And Brady's electing not to even go for the play as they are calling it a day. Nice game, though. Brady played a good game.
They certainly did. Every year, they do the same thing. They come up there, and they're outmanned. But it's a gutty team, show a lot of spirit. They were having a lot of fun.
For Somersworth, their second victory in a row, and the second shutout in a row.
That's what's amazing now. They're going up to Newport now, and Newport knowing that no team have scored on them, so that'll be some intimidation on Somersworth's part.
So the final score this afternoon, 21-0, Somersworth over Bishop Brady. We'll take this timeout, and then we'll wrap it up on the sideline.
Here Care Pharmacy cares, and now in Rochester,